So Brexit was voted the 23rd of June 2016 by 52% of the UK population during a referendum that was led by David Cameron. This means that UK will leave the European Union the 29th of March 2019 after being part of it for 43 years. Listening to the medias, this might impact the economy, the politics and the cultures in many ways, good or bad. But what do people think about it? We, as international students from France and Japan, will give our opinion about it, and then we'll ask other people, how do they feel about Brexit? What do they think about it? My name is Guillaume, and I am a French student.
Hi, I'm Hikari. I'm from Japan.
Okay, so what do people in Japan think about Brexit?
Well, I think many Japanese people are not interested in the Brexit, and also we have only few knowledge about Brexit. British people can't travel freely within your country. So I think many Japanese people think the UK shouldn't have left the EU. What about you?
For French people, it's pretty scary because there was like three big countries that were all in Europe, which was like France, Germany and UK, and now UK left. So it feels like France and Germany have to carry on, and they will have to pay even more to support the European Union. So it's pretty much dangerous for Europe, and I think it's pretty bad because it has been created to avoid any wars, and it works out pretty well. So yeah, that's pretty scary. Mm-hmm. Now let's move on to the interviews.
Hi, my name is Maria Magidaki. I am from Greece. I believe that Brexit is not a beneficial thing, definitely for Europe, because I think it's gonna influence the way we, as a new generation that need to find employment and continue with our studies, will be affected, since definitely the status change is gonna affect both our ability to work in Britain, and also it will make the studies become more expensive, which will mean more people will not have access to better higher education that we believe Britain to have.
My name is Tiril Aurora-Reksnes. I'm from Norway. When the UK decided to leave the EU, I was very disappointed because for a lot of the members and non-members of the EU, the UK have always been a member with a voice of reason. Norway is not a member of the EU, but we are a member of the EEA, and thereby a sort of members, and we follow a lot of the regulations that the EU have. When England or the UK decided to leave the EU, Norway did not really feel that this was a problem, but we are very interested in seeing what will happen now that for the first time a country, and quite a major country and member of the EU, are leaving the EU, and how this will affect not only the EU but also the rest of the world.
I'm from Spain. I don't like the idea of Brexit, and also I think that Brexit leads to discrimination of other races in Europe. And yeah, that's pretty much my thoughts.
About Brexit, well, I'm not really sure, but when I was discussing it with my parents, they said it's really good for the economy to sort of break away from the EU. So I'm trying to take all things into account.
And because I'm an international student, I don't know much about Brexit. I was like preparing to come, and I just got an email that my tuition fees will be higher than for the English people. It wasn't a little lot, it was like £225, but it was really weird to get that email like months before I come here.
My name is Evan Ragg. Unfortunately, I wasn't the right age to vote when the referendum happened. But if I could have voted, I would have voted to stay, because I think the benefits of being a member of the EU far outweigh any possible gain.
I don't like Brexit because I think it's a really dividing approach, and I think it's caused out of fear maybe of being not united but losing money. I think it's a quite agreed approach, at least. Whenever I've talked to people, they always talk about the money. And I think this divide between the rest of the European Union and other European countries is devastating, actually, and it is going to lead to a lot of hate and discrimination, and it's not what I want to see in my country.
My name is Jack. I think that it's not very good. I don't like it, man. I wasn't old enough to vote in the referendum when it was happening, but if I had been, I would have voted in, to be honest with you. I think it's better, man, if we stay in the EU. But you know, it's just, what annoys me is I feel like people at the top aren't really like prepared to deal with like the situation. You know, I feel like we need strong leadership at this point. And you know, we gotta battle through and get the best out of a bad situation.
Hi, I'm Eloise. Well, that's a big question. I was too young to vote at the time in the referendum, but I think if I'd been old enough, I probably would have said stay in. Only because of the uncertainty faced, and I feel like there's a lot of like kind of, yeah, not knowing what the future's gonna be like. But yeah, sometimes I guess you've got to take risks, but maybe not this time. Yeah.
My name's Will Murphy. So what always interests me about Brexit is that the buzzword seems to be uncertainty. People talk about uncertainty of what might happen if we were to leave as being a big reason to vote Remain. But the way I see it, I feel like there's uncertainty either way, because there were a lot of talks about reforms being made to the existing agreement if the UK was to stay in the European Union. So for me, that's not the most compelling reason to remain or to vote out, for that matter. But I can see why a lot of people, especially young people, when you look at how they voted, tended to be Remain with the sort of 16 to 25 category, because of the thought of having to have their studies interrupted, international students were worrying about if they could continue their degree or practice, for example, medicine in the UK, which is, I understand, is a big problem, and I can empathise with, especially in London, as such a cosmopolitan city in the UK. But I mean, what's interesting to see is that the big gap between how people say they might vote and how they actually vote, because I don't think anyone was really anticipating the result in the same way that the US election, a lot of people weren't expecting Trump to necessarily win that also. So it's interesting. It kind of shows a lot about human behaviour, the difference maybe between what people say and what people do. So yeah, a lot of things to think about when it comes to Brexit.
Hi, I'm Kay.
Hi, I'm Pamela.
We have interviewed 5 internationals and 5 British people this time. Is there anything you found interesting?
Well, it seems everyone disagreed Britain leaving European Union.
Right. I don't know about older generations, because this time we only asked Brex students. But I really found interesting that all of the interviewees answer that the Brexit is not a good idea.
Yeah. Well, many young people who hope to stay European Union to get more interaction with overseas, there was a lot more people who voted to leave because security and immigrant concerns.
Mm-hmm. As it turns out, the referendum was dominated by the Leave camp. Is it's gonna be real in 2019? We'll see what happens.